Rumors abound on the imminent release of Apple's next CPU, the M1X. Will Apple release the M1X in the 24-inch iMac? What level of performance can we expect? Let's get into it. The rumors of the new 24-inch iMac to be announced are getting people very excited, and the next Apple Silicon chip, the M1X, looks to be a powerhouse. If you haven't had a chance to use an M1-based system, then you have been missing out on what I would call the best entry-level computer Apple has ever introduced. Now, I was skeptical when Apple announced the transition to Apple Silicon at last year's WWDC. Of course, this was just after my experience of running macOS on Threadripper, so that may have had something to do with it. However, I can now say that skepticism was unwarranted and Apple is scaling performance very well and is on to something with Apple Silicon. I have had my M1 Mac Mini for several months now and have been very impressed. The single-core performance has been outstanding. It's very quick and snappy, and its multi-core performance has been admirable considering Apple has been advertising this as an 8-core chip. The M1 chip has 4 performance cores and 4 efficiency cores. When I compare it to my i7 Mac Mini that has 6 cores and 12 threads, I get a very similar Cinebench R23 multi-core score. You just have to let that little Intel Mac Mini breathe a little if you want to get that extra 10% in performance. And compared to x86 chips and PCs, its multi-core performance is very much akin to 6-core processors from AMD and Intel. However, the M1X is rumored to have 12 cores in total, with 8 performance cores and 4 efficiency cores. This will bring a level of performance that is unprecedented in a consumer-grade, non-pro Apple desktop computer. This will totally disrupt the performance expectations going forward for Macs. Let's do a quick look at how. Last November, I plotted the Geekbench 5 multi-core performance of the entire Mac CPU lineup, which, at the time, was totally Intel-based. Now, I know this is a busy chart, since it contains 27 Intel CPUs within Macs. So let's break it down to the computer segments represented. So first, we'll add some division lines. And at the top, we have the Mac Pro and its CPU variants from 8 cores to 28 cores. Then we have the iMac Pro, now discontinued, with up to 18 cores. Then we have the 27-inch iMac with up to 10 cores. The 21.5-inch iMac with up to 6 cores. The venerable Mac Mini with up to 6 cores. And then the 3 laptops in the 16-inch MacBook Pro, the 13-inch MacBook Pro, and finally the MacBook Air. Now, when Apple released the M1 chip, the multi-core performance was very impressive, scoring in the range of 7,409 in the Geekbench database to my very own M1 Mac Mini score of 7,709. What is most impressive is that it scored higher than 60% of Intel CPUs in the Intel-based Mac lineup. That's just the first Apple Silicon chip. The M1X will add 4 additional performance cores. Now, the performance cores run at 3.2 GHz, while the efficiency cores run at only 2 GHz. When you look at the split in performance, you find out that in the M1 chip, the 4 performance cores do a little more than 70% of the work. Now, if the core frequency stays the same in the M1X chip, then doing a little math and adding 4 additional performance cores, we can estimate that the multi-core performance will reach just over 13,000 at 13,150. That just about equals the 18-core iMac Pro that used to cost upwards of $7,000. That's insane. I guess that explains why Apple recently discontinued the iMac Pro before it was totally embarrassed by the new M1X chip. Looking at the Geekbench 5 multi-core chart, only the 16-core, 24-core, and 28-core Mac Pros would score higher. Wow, think of it. The second iteration of Apple Silicon in the M1X is kind of a knockout blow to all the Intel-based Macs. Now, I am not the biggest fan of Geekbench due to the amount of variability in the scores. So it is possible the score could be lower, somewhere in the mid-12,000 range, but that's still insane. I do feel more confident in calculating the scores in Cinebench since they are much more repeatable, and that worked really well in my Intel 11th Gen Rocket Lake performance calculations. Using Cinebench R23, my M1 Mac Mini scored 7,817 in multi-core. Using that score as the basis and adding 4 additional performance cores, I would calculate the score of the M1X to be 13,268. Now, I know that some people are estimating even higher scores, and CPU Monkey contains a much higher score of 14,450. In my calculations, to achieve that higher score, the clock frequency in the M1X would need to be higher than in the M1. However, CPU Monkey still lists it at the same 3.2 GHz frequency as the M1. So, if the frequencies remain the same, then I would expect scores closer to the low 13,000 range. When Apple releases the M1X, it is going to reset the expectations for Apple desktop computers. I am excited for the M1X whenever Apple decides to release it. I can't wait to get my hands on this chip and then benchmark it against Intel and AMD chips to get a sense of its performance against PCs. If you learned something from this video and would like to see more, then please hit that like button and consider subscribing with notifications on so that I, along with the YouTube algorithm, will know you'd like to see more content like this. Thank you all so very much for watching. Stay safe out there, and I will see you in the next one.